Testing if you wish. Nina, English.
Thank you for this very interesting theme that you have put forth so that we can be able to participate in it. On the convention of the AU, there's another level on top of that. And if what the AU does should be ratified at the continental level, it would be good. And then at the sub-regional level, this has to be also accepted in the on the sub-regions. Sometimes we see in the Central African region, the convention of the AU must go up to the national level in their laws. And this is in line with what Senegal said. Then beyond the security politics and all the issues to do with the federating organ on cyber governance and data protection, beyond that, there is a point which hasn't been raised, that is data and how it is protected and governed. How should we expose internet information to users? We need to get the markets and have new markets. This aspect hasn't been tackled, and this is regrettable. This is an aspect on big data and artificial intelligence, which is very important and is going to affect things tomorrow. How do you think this is going to happen? Do you think the states, are going to say, well, I have my data on Bizumu method, everyone is using it, I can use that? No, that way we will have a real problem at the AU level. And here I want to say, how will Africa move into the fourth industrial revolution and be at the level of the other continents without this? I thank you.
Hello, could I jump in? Thank you very much for giving me the floor. Can you hear me well? Thank you very much. Hello, everyone and distinguished panelists. I would like to thank you for organizing this timely session. I'm Amir Mukhabri from Iranian Academic Community. Isn't time to form a legally binding framework for cross-border data governance within the United Nations to prevent strategic misuses of national big data of country for illegitimate purposes by some dominant governance and international digital platform? This framework could help digital trust and transparency at international level and could help formation of an accountability framework for dominant actors in internet. And it could also guarantee development rights, the rights to development of developing countries and fundamental rights of users, and prevent formation of new data colonialism. My question is that, what would be the contribution of Global Digital Compact to address these critical issues and to establish drafting process of United Nations Convention on Data Sovereignty? At the end, I would like to request my comments to reflect it. Thank you. I would like to request my comments to be reflected in session after. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity.